specifically how to reach difficult demographics, I use the word lightly. And the particular example we were looking at were Staffordshire University student nurses at the Shrewsbury sub-campus, which is a group of about 300 students based at a hospital, many of whom are mature students. They are local to the area, and they don't necessarily engage with the larger campuses. There's a large proportion of student parents and student carers in those assets. It's basically all the difficult demographics rolled into one. If we look at how best to reach the area.
And I sort of tried to nag you into making it as specific as possible, which meant I also took away the opportunity for you to look at other groups of people who you feel are excluded. Hopefully you'll be able to come up with stuff that has resonance for that. And where are you at? Do you think, I mean, interesting with that group, have you even decided whether you think social media is in the slightest bit relevant to them? Because
I think the conclusion we reached was that it was, but it was a long way from being fully developed and useful to all.
I think it was quite interesting that this group of students had already kind of mobilised themselves into a student council of sorts anyway. So obviously the kind of format was there. So perhaps it's more about listening to their own, you know, the systems they've set up themselves, and then seeing what that means for the union as a way of engaging them, rather than setting something up for them, actually seeing what they've done themselves.
And I think just listening to you makes me think that one of the qualities of the stuff that you've seen around social media in Birmingham democracy is that it is very much both online and offline, and what happens in the real world is as important, if not more important, than what. And sometimes the real world triggers internet stuff, and sometimes the internet stuff triggers. But it's about a culture that says we are our own people, we talk to each other, we share a lot with each other, we collaborate with each other. And that can be around anything. And some people are able to convene around some subjects, and some people are able to convene around other subjects. But understanding that mindset that says this isn't about formal structures, it's about informal structures and what's possible, may or may not help with any of you.
I think how groups are very quickly created around a single issue and can dissipate very quickly. How there's nothing to stop people belonging to any number of groups simultaneously. How those groups evolve if they're a single issue group, and then, you know, they get more responsibility, and then that becomes more formal, and then some people are starting to think, actually, it was the informality of this that I liked, and they're trying to move away. It's how to kind of follow the unorganised, organised, if you see what I mean, follow them through their process.
So you've got a couple of hours now.